Hello dear students, we will start today one new chapter, refraction through a lens. You know what is refraction? Refraction is a phenomenon of bending of a ray of light when it passes from one transparent medium to another transparent medium. That is refraction. So what is lens? A lens is a transparent refractive medium bounded by either two spherical surfaces or one surface spherical and other surface is plane. So mainly there are two types of lens. One is convex lens, another is concave lens. So you see the convex lens. This is convex lens. Convex lens thick in the middle and thin at its periphery. So this is convex lens. Convex lens is otherwise known as converging lens. Why? So when a ray of light passes through it, it converges. It converges the ray. So it is called converging lens. Main convex lens three types. One is biconvex, plano-convex and concavo-convex. What is biconvex? If both side convex, that is biconvex, and if one side plane, another convex, that is plano-convex, another, that is if one side concave, another side convex, that is concavo-convex. So another type of lens, that is concave lens. This is the concave lens. Concave lens thick at periphery but thin at the middle. This concave lens is otherwise known as diverging lens. So why it called diverging lens? Because the lens diverges the light rays which are incident on it. So it also three types. One is biconcave, both side concave, and it plano concave, one side plane, another side concave, and convexo concave, one side convex, another side concave. So there are three types of concave lens. So one important thing I will tell you, that convexo concave and concavo convex both are same two surfaces. One is convex, another is concave. So what the difference in their shape and action? A concave convexo lens is thicker in the middle and has a converging action, while the convexo concave lens is thinner in the middle and has a diverging action. So this is about the lens. So one thing, the lens is made of a set of prisms. See, this is a convex lens, so many prisms are set. So this convex lens is also concave lens, so prisms are set. So this is convex and concave lens. Now you come to that some important terms related to lens. So before going to see the diagram and see, this is, there are two spheres. This is one center, C1 take. This is the center of one sphere, C2 take. So this is the lens. This is how we take the midpoint, that is optical center. So you take this lens. Take, this is the convex lens. The convex lens are taken from two spheres. So this is the center of curvature of the lens. There are two center of curvature. If you join the two center of curvature and through the midpoint, that is the optical center, became the principal axis. Like this, to take two spheres, and this is the concave lens. There are also two centers, and the other two centers, C1, C2, and also the midpoint, the optical center. If you join also, this is the principal axis. So many important terms are related to the lens. One by one, I will tell you. First term, center of curvature. The center of the sphere from which lens is a part is called center of curvature. And come to radius of curvature. The radius of the sphere which lens is a part is called radius of curvature. But one important thing, for equiconvex and equiconcave, both radius of curvature equal. Come to principal axis. It is the line joining the centers of curvature of two surfaces of a lens is called principal axis. Now come to optical center. Optical center is the point on the principal axis of the lens, so that any ray of light passes undeviated through it. Any line passes through the optical center, it has no deviation, undeviated it passes. Now come to focal point. There are two focal points, one first focal point and second focal point. So first focal point of convex lens, the point on the principal axis, so that the ray coming from it, those rays are coming from that point, after refraction passes parallel to the principal axis. This point is called first focal point of convex lens. Like this, in concave lens, the first focal point, the point on the principal axis when the rays are coming, appear to meet at that point, and after refraction passes parallel to the principal axis. Now come to second focal point of convex lens. This is the point on the principal axis, the second focal point. The rays coming parallel to the principal axis, what happen after refraction, they meet at a point. So this is F2, the second focal point. And come to the second focal point of concave lens. The point on the principal axis, the rays coming parallel to the principal axis, what happen after refraction, they appear to diverge from a point. That point is called second focal point of concave lens. Now come to focal plane. What is focal plane? The plane passing through the focal point and normal to the principal axis is called focal plane. Focal plane also two types, first focal plane, second focal plane. What is first focal plane? The plane passing through the first focal point of the lens and normal to the principal axis is the first focal plane. And the plane passes through the second focal point of the lens and normal to the principal axis is called second focal plane. Now come to focal length. Very important. What is focal length? The distance of focus from the optical center of the lens is called focal length. Here also two types of focal length, first focal length, second focal length. The distance from the optical center from the first focal point is called first focal length, and the distance from the optical center to the second focal point is called second focal length. So now very important, some important points about focal length and focus. If the medium of the lens, both sides are same medium, then the both focal lengths are equal. That is F1 is equal to F2. If usually, suppose you tell that focus of a lens, usually you have to think the second focal point. If focal length, you will tell of the focal length of a focal lens, that is second focal length. Convex lens has a real focus. Why? Because the rays coming parallel to the principal axis, after refraction through the lens, they meet at a point. In the convex lens, though there is real focus. In convex lens, they after refraction appears to meet at a point, therefore there is a virtual focus. So now come to the focal length. The mainly focal length depends upon two factors. One is refractive index. So refractive index of the lens with respect to the medium is more, focal length more. That would be direct proportional. If refractive index with respect to the medium is less, focal length less. So there is a direct proportional to the refractive index. Example, suppose you put a lens in water instead of air, the focal length increases because the refractive index of water is more than air. Now come to second point, radius of curvature. If radius of curvature more, focal length also more. So it is direct proportional to the focal length, or focal length direct proportional to radius of curvature. So example, thick lens. Thick lens has the radius less than the radius of thin lens. So therefore thick lens has less focal length than the thin lens. Now come to very important thing. If the part of a lens is covered, what happens to the image? What happens to the focal length? What happens to the image? Its focal length is not affected. The position, size and nature of image do not change, but only the intensity of the image decreases as light entering the lens decreases. So these are the important terms about our lens. So you study this and write the notes, then you go to the next. Okay, thank you.